Hello guys, this is Rahul here. I am back with another tutorial. This time we have the software RealFlow. Today this lecture would be related to introduction and interface of RealFlow, and I hope you like this software, and I'd be explaining many things about this software. Let's now move on to the interface of RealFlow. Here you can see when you open this software you get a window ahead in front of your eyes. This window is the project window in which you can create your new project or open an existing project. In this you have to type the name of your new project, and below is the second line is related for the location of the project. If you don't want to set in the default directory of RealFlow, you can shift the project to another drive so that you can keep it safe, not in your C drive. Then you can do it with your D drive where Windows is not installed. In that drive you can keep this thing. So now I'm creating this new project. Here you can see the main window in which all the effects and all that thing happen. You can even change the view. You can have the view of Maya or 3ds Max, that is a quad view. Here you can see the quad view, and there are many viewing option as well as a renderer player is there. This is the render player of RealFlow. In this you can see the basic texture for the liquid which you create. You can apply basic texture in RealFlow to see the effect of the liquid. This is your node view in which the graph is created for the particular thing, in which you can make the necessary changes. Even there is a script view, you can type in a script for that particular effect if you want to see that particular effect in the in your video, in your this thing project. And there are many views you can see over here, and even there are some custom settings which you can change or toggle with if you know them properly. And you will be knowing all the settings in the coming future from my end. And now let's try with the emitter. This is a circle emitter over here. This emitter emits particle which can be converted into mesh, and that mesh can be used in your other software to create that final effect in your other software. And this is how you can rotate and do all the things. Even you can scale the objects. And on the right hand side you can see this is a hub written over here. This hub stands for basically the main component of your connectors. Like if you don't connect the your circle emitter to the hub, you won't be getting your desired effect with it. If like you're creating a collision effect in the software, you won't be getting that effect. Here is the stimulation key by which your emitter starts emitting its particles. Like it basically a kind of an animation creator. It creates animation for you, and then you have a reset key. Whenever you make a necessary changes in the in your emitter, kindly reset and then click on stimulate. Don't directly click on stimulate, it won't be creating any effect over there. First reset, then stimulate. And these are some of your basic settings by right clicking, and this is basically the effect for that particular thing by which you can create it. Here you can see all the things, and this is the play button. First you have to press the back key, it will go to zero frame, and then you can play the play button. And if you want to create a loop effect by which it does not stop playing and it goes on again and again, then you have to click on this key. It would loop your playing option, and the effect would go from 0 to 200, 0 to 200. Even you can increase your frame size for your particular desired effect. If you want to create a chocolate sauce effect or water effect or another effect by which like a wave or all that thing, then you can create it. So this is the first introduction lecture related to RealFlow, and I would be now saving this project, and I would be catching up you in the further lengthy lecture related to RealFlow. Thank you guys, thank you for watching this video, and do subscribe to my channel, do follow me on Twitter, Facebook and my blog, and thank you very much.